Can you able to see the screen? All of you see, just check. Okay, so today's class will start with continuation of last class, that is addresses, logical addresses. Okay, so we discussed in the last class classful addressing, and we have also seen the disadvantages of classful addressing, okay, and how classless addressing will overcome it. Okay, so we have seen in the last class that in classless addressing, okay, so we have actually 32 bits, and in that there are two hierarchy, means there are two parts. One is called the prefix, the first part. The second part is called the suffix. Okay, so you have seen this, and given IPv4 address, something like this. Okay, this address we call it as a CIDR addressing or slash notation addressing. Okay. This slash n indicates the mask or the prefix length, okay, and this is the address. Okay, so here for example, any random address along with this prefix length, if they give, you should be able to find out the first address and the last address. Okay, how do you find the first address? First address by making the last 32 minus n bits to 0. N here indicates the prefix length. For example, here you can see here, this is the given address, and they are asking you to find out the length, first address. Okay, so what is the first address in the block? This is a random address, something they have given, but they have given mentioned that this is a slash n notation and this is 28. So what we should do here, we should subtract 32 minus 28 and I'll be getting 4. Okay, so this is the binary version of the address, and in this binary version you make the last 4 bits to 0. Okay, so whatever you are getting this address, this we call it as a first address. Okay, now let us see how to find the last address. Last address, similar to this, instead of making zeros, if I make it once, then I will get the last address. Okay, so let us see that. See here, the same address, its binary version. So 0111 was there. So instead of making all 4 zeros, this is made 4 ones. So we are getting 47 here, dot 47. So this is the last address. And how do you find the number of address? You can find by using this formula, 2 to the power of 32 minus n. Okay, so the n is 28 here. So 2 to the power of 4, the difference will be 4. How do you find the total number of addresses? Is 16, 2 to the power of 4, okay, 32 minus 28. Okay, so this is how actually we will find, this is one way. Other way is using the mask. Okay, so what is this mask? Mask is this one. So we have slash 28 na in the given address. So 28 means it indicates the prefix length. Okay, so this entire thing, I can divide this into two parts. This is prefix. So first 28s are 1. If I make it, this is prefix length. So next 4 bits, whatever you can see, it is a host address. So host, it indicates the host. So it is 4 bit. Okay, so we will make this a mask by taking 28 bits as 1 and last 4 bits as 0. In this also, we can find the first address, last address, and the number of total number of addresses. Okay, and this is very, very useful, because this method, it is particularly useful when we are writing a program, because we are using AND, OR, NOT operation. These three operations we are using. So it is very easy to find the first address, last address. See here, what we need to do? Take the address in binary, okay, and take the mask and do AND, okay. Bitwise bit, you do AND operation, and whatever you are getting, you just see the first address only we are getting, and you can also see, observe, the last four bits are replaced by four zeros here, okay. So this is the first address. We got it by making a ANDing with the mask, okay. So this is first address we could find with the AND operation. Then how do you find the second last address? Okay, so how we'll use instead of AND operation OR, and then the NOT operation will use it to make the complement of the mask. It's clear for you? So complement of the mask means instead of making once the first 28, we will make it as zero. The last four will make it as zero. Zeros were there, so we'll make it as one. So if I OR, okay, by binary bitwise OR operation, one OR zero is one. Okay, and okay, 1 1 or is 1. So if I do like this, okay, so I'll be getting the last address. You observe here, the last four bits are changed to 1 1 1. Okay, so the you can take any of the address. This is how we will find the first address, the last address. Okay, how do you find the total number of addresses then? The total number of addresses, you can do it. I'll put a slideshow. Okay, one second. This I converted PDF to PPT, so that's why this is not in the order, but okay, manageable. Okay, so this is first address, second address, and number of addresses can be found by complementing the mask. Okay. So the same what we use, the NOT gate of the mask, same thing you take it. Its value in decimal, if you write, it is 15. So add 15 to 1 to this 15, then you will get 16. Okay. So 16 is the total number of addresses. Okay. So you can see here, this is the first address. This is the first address, the last address. And then we have here, this is the same thing in binary, and this is a decimal. So this is 32 is the first address, 47 is the last address. Total number of addresses will be, total will be 16. Is it clear? So this is for this particular address block. Okay. And one more thing you should note down, very important thing. The first address in a block is normally not assigned to any device. Okay. See, it is used only to just represent which organization which company, okay, it belongs to the rest of the world. Okay, so this is the network address of the organization or the company or anything. Okay, so this is first address is normally not used, and it is not assigned to any of the devices. Two levels of hierarchy we have. I told you prefix and the host, that is suffix. It is similar to a telephone exchange. How in telephone exchange we have this hierarchy, is it not? First three will be area code, next exchange office, then we'll have the subscribers. Similarly, we have here first 28 bits. In this example I'm taking, it's not always 28 bits. In the example, what you have taken in the last problem, the 28 bits will be the network prefix, and the next four bits, okay, so which will indicate the host address. Is it clear? See here. In class A, this prefix length will be either, okay, 8 bits or 16 bits or 24 bits. It was like that. But this is a classless addressing. Though there is no fixed prefix. So we can have 28 bits also. Is it clear? So this clearly indicates this is a classless address. Okay. That is what I told already. It is a prefix which defines the network. And then rightmost 32 minus n will actually define the host or the nodes which connected to the network. Okay, so this we have seen. Okay, coming to this diagram. See here, we have three subnets. Subnetting. Okay, I told you subnetting and supernetting in the last class. What is subnetting? Subnetting is nothing but dividing the a large addresses group into smaller groups. Okay, so that's why the entire network is divided into subnets. That's the name, which is subnetting. Okay, and here you can see the one example. Okay, so this is through the router, the entire network is connected to the internet. Okay, and how from the router, see how the IP address are assigned. Just observe here. As I told you here, the first address. Okay, so the network is this one. So network will be indicated by the first address. What if this address is taken? We can take any random address. So it is 17.12.14.0/26. Okay, so this is the network, entire network. Okay, so in this we have divided into three subnets. Okay, and which are these three subnets? You can see here. The first is subnet one. The first starting address is 17.12.14.0. Okay, /27. Okay, so /27 I am taking because this is a prefix length for this particular subnet. It's clear? Okay, and you observe here, this is not used anywhere. Okay, see these systems. So this is starting only from 1 to 31. Okay, so here we have 32, 0 to 31 means 32 systems addresses. Okay, so are connected to this particular Ethernet. Okay, so this is the address which will indicate only this particular network. And observe here, this is one, the first device. And the second device will be the connection to the router, because this anyhow one of the systems should be act like a router. So here this router is shared by these three subnets. So this router address is taken it as 14.2, second address. It's clear? First address 0 is the network address. Then the next one, second one, which is 14.1, which is one of the devices. And then this is a router. And rest all 3, 4, 5 up to 31, we can connect to the these devices. Okay, so total 32 devices are there, including the router. Is it clear? Okay, coming to the subnet 2. In subnet 2, the next, it's ended here with 31, is it not? Now we need to start with 32. See here, the network address, first address will become now, seeing the last address of the subnet 1, the next address will become the first address in case of subnet 2. So we can see here, this has become 32 here. Okay. So 32, it is not assigned to any of the devices, it is a network address. Then 33 is one of the device, 34 is a router, and rest all up to 47 will be the devices address connected to this particular network. It's clear? Okay, so up to 47 we have used the last address. Now in the next turn, it should start with 48. Okay, so if they give you the starting address, okay, and they'll ask you to divide this into three sub blocks and tell the final address, you can do it by doing like this, okay, and they'll also give you how many devices are there in each subnet, then you can around say do this problem. Okay, is it clear now? Okay, this is the three-level hierarchy in the IPv4 address. You can see here 26 bits. Subnet 1 is this, 26 bits. And 1 is used for the subnet prefix, and the remaining 5 are the host address. So in this case, because subnet 2 and subnet 3 are actually shared here. Shared in the, you can see here, this entire subnet. Okay, but these two are shared by this. Is it not? That's why you can see. Okay, so here the subnet prefix will be 2. Okay, subnet 2 and 3 will actually share the same subnet. This is a very important problem. With this, you will understand how actually ISP, okay, internet service provider, will grant a block of addresses. This problem, I will share this PPT to you, but understand, okay? Please understand, this is a very important problem. Okay, some address is given 190.100.0.0/16. So slash 16 means prefix length is 16 bits. So it is almost similar to class B addressing, and class B addressing will provide 65,536 addresses. Okay, so this we know already, but they have given this addressing. The ISP needs to distribute these addresses to three groups of customers as follows. Okay, so enter, it has now 65,536 addresses. This has to be divided into the required customers. See, for example, for the first group will come, it has 64 customers and each needs 256 addresses. Okay, so they ask for this requirement. The second group will come and they'll ask, they have 128 customers and each needs 128 addresses. Okay, and the third group will come and ask for 128 customers and each needs 64 addresses. This is three groups are there. Now, entire your ISP 65,536 addresses, you have to divide, okay, to first group, second group, third group, and you have to design the sub-blocks, and also you have to see, okay, so not all 65,000 are used. If you just multiply 64 into 256 plus 128 into 128 plus 128 into 64, okay, so you'll get some value. You have to subtract with that, then you have to say what is the remaining available after allocation, also how many addresses still the ISP is having to distribute to some other groups. Is it clear question? Did you understand the question? Already started writing your attendance, huh? I did not tell you, now you listen here. Can you able to see the screen and understand the question now? Okay, ISP has to provide these many addresses. How it will do it, please see, this is very important. Okay, all of you understand this problem. Okay, see, okay, group one, each customer needs 256 addresses. Okay, how many are there? Such 64. 64 customers, and each customer requires 256. You need to find out what is the host address and the prefix and the suffix. I need to find the prefix and the suffix. With this 256 value, I'll get to know what is the number of host required. Okay, so this is given by log to the base 2, 256. What all the address, the capital N, this we can take it as capital N. So log to the base 2, capital N will give me bits which are required to define each host. 8 bits are required. So 32 minus 8, if I do it, that is suffix na. So 32 minus suffix will be yielding the prefix length. So I'll get to know 24. Okay, so I'll write slash 24 for all my addresses. So this is the beginning address. I'll take it 190.100.0.0/24. This is my first customer. Okay, address. In first customer, the first address. Okay, so here 0 to 255 it is giving, because each customer requires 256. So 0 to 255 means 256. And now second customer 1.0 to 1.255. Similarly, up to 64 customers are there, 63.0 to 63.255. So this is the design of first block or the first group. Is it clear? Okay, so let us see the second group. Second group, we have stopped where till 63.255. okay, so next address will be 64.0. so that will be used here, the first customer of the second group, 64.0/25. this has changed now because it requires, then it's not required 256, it requires 128 addresses. So if you take log to the base 2, 128, it comes around 7. It's 7 only. 2 to the power of 7 is 128. So 7 bits are needed for host, means prefix length, if we find it is 32 minus 7, it becomes 25. Okay. So you can see here 20. Is it clear? You have seen, right? So up to 0 to 128, because here how many customers are there? 128 customers, and each require 128 addresses. So 128 into 128, find out what is the total. Similarly, 64 into 256, find out what is the total. Okay, keep add with this address. Okay, now the last one we will see. The last one, similar to this, we will do it. Okay. Yeah, so the 127.255, it has stopped. So here we'll take the next one, 128.0. That is the first address, and 26 will be calculated log to the base 264, which is nothing but 6. 6, so 32 minus 6 will become 26. So this is my mask or the slash n value, prefix length 26. Is it clear? So now similar to this, first customer will have 128.0 to 128.63, because each requires only 64 addresses. Okay, 0 to 63 means 64. Is it clear? And similar to last, 128th customer will have, okay, 159.255, and the total will be 128 into 64. If you multiply, you will be getting 8192. Now add these three totals. Okay, first group total, second group total, and the third group total. And this is around 40,960. That's it. The number of allocated addresses by the ISP is only 40,960. It should be subtracted from 65,536. So you will be getting the remaining addresses. This is the final solution. We have done this blocking, sub-blocking. Okay, group one. 0 to 63.255, group 2 64.0 to 127.255, and here how actually the customers, this 64 will have the address, that also should be written. Okay, so customer 1 will have this address, customer 64 address will have this. Okay, so similarly group 2, group 3 is done, and also the remaining addresses, how many are still remaining. Okay, so that also you can write down. So this indicates how ISP having 65,536 addresses is divided among these three groups, and still some more are remaining. How many remaining? 24,000 around are remaining. It's clear now? This problem, very, very important. You understand the question now? And solution. Please read once again. Very important problem. This is the final solution. Okay, one more thing I wanted to tell you. Okay, so next I should do DHCP. Before going to DHCP, okay, someone wants to join the meeting now. What is the time now? 11:20 already. All of you write down your names in the chat. Okay, so I will be conducting a quiz. Okay, and also because I am your lab teacher. Okay, so one or two experiments will be explained. Okay, regarding your CCN lab. And a quiz will be there on Saturday, this Saturday only, okay, on these laboratory experiments. Okay, I think you people have your records with you. Do you have records with you? Have you taken to your hometown or wherever you are? So you should start writing the except the no, you don't have, huh? Those who have, you can just start writing the experiments. It is there in the manual, is it not? Manual, it is given. And you can just leave the result part. Except result part, you can write rest all, okay, programs and all. And we will be demonstrating one or two programs each week, okay? And then you one quiz will be like, it is like Viva, for Viva, whether you have understood or not, it will be conducted on Saturday. Okay, is it clear? Okay, so be prepared. And you, if you have online manual with you, please go through it. I will also share if you don't have. Is it clear? Okay, so all of you have written. 43 students are there. Okay, all of you can write your name in the USN in your chat box, so that I will store it for the okay, so I will stop now for today's class. So important problem I have done, how to get the subnetting classification. Okay, so in the next class, this completes the classful and classless addressing. Okay, so in next class I'll be doing the so next class we will finish this module itself. Okay, so this module is consisting of, it's a very big module actually. Okay, so after this I'll give you one quiz. It's clear? One quiz will be based on this module now, third module, which is actually wireless LAN. We started with wireless LAN, then Bluetooth, and then we saw some connecting devices, and then network layer. Under network layer again we have seen all these things. Okay, we have seen the addressing, classless, classful addressing, and how to make a sub blocks, and IPv4 initially how actually the network layer functions. Okay, virtual, it can be virtual circuit network, or it is a packet switching network, which is a datagram version, or it is a virtual circuit, so connectionless or connection oriented. Is it clear? So this is the complete module. Next class I'll be completing this module. We'll start with the fourth module. Fourth module is transport, a continuation of network layer. It is regarding the protocol, okay, and more working of the network layer. Is it clear? Okay, so we'll stop here. Next class we will see. All of you must have written now. Okay, so we'll end now.